Hi again, folks, back with another reaction video. This one is for Whitney Houston, Greatest Love of All, live from Arista Records 15th anniversary concert, 1990. I also have a reaction to I Want to Dance with Somebody from the same night as this. And off the back of that video, I got a few more requests for Whitney Houston, and this was one of the requests. Actually, the person who requested this one, username MW. So thanks for the request. And just before we get into this, like the disclaimer states at the beginning, I do have to pause the video fairly regularly to avoid the copyright blocking. So be aware of that. I will have to pause and interject. It's the easiest way for me to give my feedback. 3, 2, 1, go. Beautiful.
I believe the children are our future. Teach them well and let them lead the way.
My goodness. Okay, so first thing, beautiful electric piano sound. Sounds a little bit like a Yamaha CP. And I know, you know, back in the 1990s, so probably that and Korg M1 were probably the real sort of big famous electric pianos that sampled like a grand piano sound. Beautiful. Lovely playing between the pianist and Whitney. Obviously, Whitney is dictating what's going on. So the pianist is having to watch her and, you know, obviously from rehearsals and so on, we'll get to know when to play, when to stop and let her take time. One of the things I really like about this, by the way, is the space between the notes. Obviously, Whitney is known very well for lots of sort of very decorative and ornate, busy kind of lines. You've got the melody and then she has these improvised lines in between. Obviously, she's a master of that. But at the same time, you can hear she's really letting each sentence finish. And she's creating anticipation there with the silence, you know, very powerful way to pull people in and get your attention is to break in between and not just, you know, dun, 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 you know, over and over and over again. I wonder what this little tick is. Wonder if you could comment. Somebody knows if you comment below. I noticed her left hand sort of doing this little tick. I don't know if that's maybe just a slight anxious tick, maybe just with a, you know, the pressure and the stress on the stage, or maybe it's just nothing to it. I don't know whether she's going to do that again. Just notice that little sort of physical gesture there. Okay, we'll pick it up again then.
Show them all the beauty they possess inside.
Phrasing is beautiful.
Give them a sense.
Again, just taking lots of time from phrase to phrase. She's not in a rush here. Really engaging, you know, from an audience perspective, you know, to hear somebody just taking their time with everything. And obviously there's a very improvised kind of style going on here. You can see with the enunciation, you know, she's very expressive with her mouth and she was able to get lots of different kind of articulation there in the words. And very dynamic, opening up and closing down. I think this might be quite special by the time the whole orchestra and band kicks in.
Let it remind us how we
you could hear a pin drop in the audience.
Used to be everybody's searching for a hero. People need someone to look up to.
Yeah, I can tell already. I mean, I've heard this song before. I'm a big fan of the film American Psycho. And I'm pretty sure this is one of the sort of monologues in that film. In fact, you may be able to see there's an American Psycho poster behind me. Let's see if I can zoom in on that. In the book as well, the Bret Easton Ellis book, American Psycho, there's a chapter on Whitney Houston. So, you know, some of you Whitney fans out there don't know that. Maybe go into that. Patrick Bateman, the main protagonist, he uses this song to talk about sort of hope and unity in mankind and so on. It's worth checking out. It's done well in the scene, obviously played by Christian Bale. That's my reference to this song, having heard it before. And so the memory I do have of this song, I can hear differences already. I mean, I recognize the chord progressions and so on. But her vocal obviously is going to take new turns, twists and turns there, you know. So she's going to keep everything very interesting for us.
I've never found anyone who fulfilled my needs. Yeah, it's a lonely place to be. So I learned to depend on me. I decided long ago never to walk in anyone's shadows.
My goodness.
If I fail, if I succeed,
really sorry to have to keep stopping again. Like I said at the beginning, I do have to do it. It's the only way I can avoid. And usually about 30 seconds or so is about as much as I can go. The last Whitney Houston video that I uploaded, you know, it took me a few goes to get that up. I had to cut certain parts out, you know, so it was very difficult. Do bear with me. Try not to get frustrated on that. Otherwise, I can't bring this video to you. Okay, so there was a moment throughout there that I got shivers the whole way down my spine, down into my arms, down my forearms as well. She's just hitting certain notes there that, you know, it's giving me chills. I'm fortunate enough that I get that. I don't think everybody gets that when they listen to music. There is a name given to that sensation. I can't think of it off the top of my head. But she's giving me those chills straight away. The confidence, I think the visual actually is helping with it. The gestures with her hands, everything goes with the intention. You know, all of her histrionics in that sense, what she's doing doesn't come across as if it's choreographed. Quite a lot of people are very choreographed when they sing and when they perform, and sometimes it can come across a bit false or a bit forced. Her little movements and gestures with the words, it just feels like it's coming straight from the heart, and it's so believable. And that's conducting the orchestra, essentially, that, the timing of it.
It's happening to me, yeah. Thank you, Lord. I found the greatest love of all inside of me. The greatest love.
Chills.
Of all.
I actually got chills in my legs at this point now. Oh my goodness. This is serious. Obviously, you know, if you've clicked on the video, you'll see I'm a pianist by profession. I teach piano, particularly classical piano. And I also play guitar. I'm a bit of a sort of rock guitarist of a band and so on. You might be able to see some of my music on here. But you know, I'm telling you that because I'm not a vocal coach. I'm not a singer, although I do write songs. My main experience with singers is from accompanying in their exams. So, you know, a lot of people, music theatre and so on, will go in and do their exams and as a accompanist, you know, so that's my main experience with singers. And she is so confident and so at home controlling everything. It's just so refreshing to see, you know. Wow. And getting a wee bit from the lyrics there, learning to love yourself is the greatest love of all. Doesn't sound conceited or egotistical, fortunately, but you know, maybe just we all can afford ourselves a little bit of self-love sometimes, because I know we can all be very hard on ourselves. So it's coming across. Maybe that's part of the shivers, you know? Beautiful. Oh, the pianist opening up a little bit now, getting a bit jazzy. I love those two minor chords there. I think they're minor sevens. Point that back again. Those two minor chords are really lovely to listen to, the way the music falls down there. The beauty they possess inside, oh, give them a sense of pride. You don't make it easier. Let the children's laughter, let it remind us how we used to be. And the other thing, obviously, I've spoken a little bit about the dynamics. It's just incredible from line to line how she just reinvents. You know, she has her style, and like everybody has a style, but it doesn't get old ever. You know, you're kind of on every line. You're not sure where she's going to take it, you know, with the little subtleties where she sort of closes up, or the deeper notes where she goes in and the other really lovely, warm, rich tone. And straight away, she's up on a powerful note. And she's really gymnastic all over the place. And yet, the vocal doesn't sound showy. You know, it's clearly really virtuosic stuff that's going on here. But it doesn't feel like it's intended to exploit technique. You know, that's what I get. I'm getting the emotion from it. It's obviously a very, very technical performance. But I'm not being dazzled by scales and runs and so on. You know, often you get bored really with that. You know, so it's purely emotion, but she's using the technique to get the emotion across. It's beautiful. That's it, Whitney. Shivers again. They can't take away my dignity, no, because the greatest. Wow. Beautiful song, this. Another thing, I guess, worth pointing out, you know, at least from a compositional point of view, is it's unusual to get a song with such a big, catchy chorus, but the chorus is kind of anticlimactic, you know. You know, a lot of the time the chorus is the part of the song where the energy builds and things move up. But you can hear it, da, 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 da. You know, the music is building just up to the chorus, and then the greatest love of all, as she delivers that line, the music relaxes into it. You know, so it's unusual. You don't get a lot of choruses where the music dips down in that sense, you know, into more like a relaxing kind of feel. Really interesting. Build. Jesus. Love of all is happening to me. So rather than belting and pushing that, you know, she's just letting it flow. I found the greatest love of all inside. Don't worry, I will go back and run that wee bit again. Again, I have to be conscious of the timing. Wow. This idea of the virtuosic thing, again, that is a point where somebody without the taste that Whitney has, you know, could let their virtuosity get the better of them. You know, and you do hear that a lot, particularly in this day and age, you know, with the talent shows, you know, I'm in the UK, so like, so Britain's Got Talent, but I think, you know, there's ones in America and so on. But a lot of what they do and try and get across as being good is the gymnastic stuff, belt, 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 you know, over the top, over the top, over the top. And well, Whitney is going in to Top Gear and she's letting us know, here we go. She still is showing restraint, you know. Not, I mean, not in the biggest complimentary way. Her level of taste about how much to give us in terms of the gymnastics without overdoing it and taking us out of the song. That's worth pointing out because there's not many people can do that. They let their ego, if you like, get the better of them, and then off they go, you know. So beautiful restraint, beautiful control. Nice bit on the bass. Oh, Whitney, this is brilliant. Is that the third time? I've lost count. Wow. Let's take a wee bit of that back in again. That was serious. We're not done yet. My goodness. Wow. Okay. I mean, that's really about as good as it gets. Let's be honest. Come on. You know, I listen to classical music for most of the time. I listen to a lot of very heavy metal stuff, play prog into all of that. But let's face it, that's about as good as it gets. My score for this is 9.5 out of 10, which is the highest yet on this reaction series. The reason why I didn't give it 10 is because my eyes are still dry. That's an indicator. I think I'm holding off on that for that song that kind of, you know, gets me. I did have all the feels in this. Wow. It's a little bit on here. I'll sort of let the rest of the video run. There's a reason why we are all still talking about Whitney. The greatest, eh? Greatest. Incredible. So don't forget to like and subscribe. And do make sure you comment. You know, you'll find I'm reacting to the videos that you suggest. These are not videos that are picked by me. So I just got a list I'm working through. So get your requests in. And I'll do them. Thanks for watching. Bye.